Good morning, students. Today we are going to study lesson number 2. The name of the lesson is See How I Work. In this lesson, we are going to study about the internal as well as external organ of the body and how we can take care of our internal organ. Let's start with the lesson. Here I am going to show you the two pictures. You have to tell me what is happening in this picture. See. What are these children doing? Can you tell me what are the children doing in this picture? Which internal organ or external organ they are using? Organs are important parts of the body. There are two types of the organ, internal organ and external organ. The organs which are located inside of a body are known as the internal organs, for example, heart, lungs, kidneys, etc. And the organs which are located outside of body are known as external organ, for example, nose, eyes, skin, lips. These are known as the external organs, which we can feel also. First internal organ we are going to study is brain. I'll show you the picture of brain to see it. See, this is human brain. The brain is located inside our body. It helps us to remember, learn and think. Our sense organ help us to see, hear, smell, taste and feel things. The brain receives signals from them and help us to think and act. It also sends signals to the different parts of the body. Brain is an important part of the body as it controls all the organs of the body. As when we touch a hot object, the brain receives a message and sends a signal to the other parts of the body to remove that particular part from that object quickly. Next, we are going to study about the human heart. I'll show you the picture of human heart. This is human heart. The heart pumps blood to the whole body. It is located towards the left side of our chest. Doing light exercise and eating healthy food is good for and essential for our heart. Do you know the size of our heart is roughly the size of our closed fist. Next internal organ we are going to study about is lungs. As we have two lungs, one is located at the right side, one is located at the left side of our body chest. When we take air inside of our body, our lungs expand, that means become bigger in size, and when we take air outside our body, the lungs contracts, that means they get smaller in size. These are the lungs. Our lungs help us to breathe. Next internal organ we are going to study about is kidney. We are having two kidneys. One is located in the right and other is located in the left part of the body. So kidneys excrete a liquid waste from our body in the form of the urine. The urine is a liquid waste that is excreted out from the body. We should drink a lot of water to keep our kidneys healthy. This is the picture of the kidneys, how kidneys look like. Next internal organ we are going to study about is stomach. The food that we eat goes into our stomach. The stomach breaks down the food that we eat. It also helps us to digest our food. Internal organ we are going to talk about is bones and muscles. Bones are present in our body. Bones are attached to. Attached means joints. Bones are joined to the muscles in our body. They give shape to our body. With the help of the bones and muscles, we are able to stand, sit, play, run. So, to keep them healthy and fit, we should drink milk daily. How we can take care of our internal organ, brain? By taking 8 hours of the sleeps, we can keep our brain healthy and strong. We should wear a helmet while we can also take care of the stomach by not eating the junk food like chowmin, Maggi, burgers, chili potatoes, etc. By eating fresh fruits and vegetables, we can keep our stomach healthy. Do you know our heart beats 72 times in a minute? Now I'm going to give you some homework. Here I'm going to show you some pictures of the internal and external organ. You have to circle the internal organ pictures, okay? From this 6 picture, you have to circle only internal organs of the body, not external. So in this lesson, we have studied about 6 internal organs. First one, brain. Second, heart. Third, lungs. Fourth, kidneys. 5th stomach, and 6th is bones and muscles. Now I'm going to show you one video on internal organs.
I cannot see some important parts of my body as they are inside my body. These are called my internal organs. My heart is like a pump. It sends blood to my whole body. My brain helps me to think. It is protected by the skull. It controls my whole body. It is the boss. It is better than the best computer. I have two lungs. They help me to breathe. My stomach helps me to break up and digest the food I eat. Although we cannot see these internal organs, we can feel their presence and prove their existence. Gently put your hand against your heart and feel the heartbeat. The doctor uses a stethoscope to feel the heartbeat. Let's do an activity. Put your lips on a mirror. As you breathe, you will leave some moisture on the mirror. This is your breath. You must always breathe properly through your nose. This is taught in yoga. Our stomach has to do a lot of work to digest our food. We should not give it extra work and make it tired by eating unhealthy junk food, which takes more time and energy to digest. I also have bones, which form the skeleton. The bones are covered with muscles. They give shape and posture to my body. They allow me to stand erect. They also protect my various internal organs. Muscles and bones help me to move. I also have red blood which flows through my body. All the parts of my body have to work properly for me to be healthy. They all work together in a team. There isn't a single part of our body that can work alone.
Today, Sid is at his family doctor's clinic with his mother. His mother has been coughing for 2 days now.
What are you doing, doctor?
I'm checking if everything is fine inside your mama's body.
But what is there inside her body? Is there something inside my body as well?
Do you also want to see what is there inside Sid's body? Come. Let's peep into his body and find out.
Oh, hello. I'm Sid's brain. Right now, Sid is thinking about something and I'm helping him to do so. Not only that, I help him solve his difficult math problems and remember his friends' birthdays. Nice meeting you. Bye.
It seems the sound is coming from somewhere here. Hello. Can you hear this sound? I'm sure you often hear this sound, isn't it? I make this sound. I am Sid's heart. Sid is eating a banana. Let's see where this banana is going.
Hello, I'm Sid's food pipe. I will help this banana reach my friend the stomach. It is right there near the tummy. I got to go now. Bye.
Let's go meet the stomach too.
Hello, I'm Sid's stomach. All the food that he eats comes to me.
Oh, something is coming. I must go. I think there is another part in there.
Hello, we are the lung twins.
We live inside Sid's chest. We help Sid in breathing.
Sid is able to sit, hold this bottle in his hand, and stand with the help of some special body parts. Do you know which body parts? These special body parts are bones and muscles.
We are the bones and muscles of Sid's body.
From sitting to standing to writing, we help him in everything.
Come on, Sid. Let's go home now. So, kids, inside Sid's body, we have found his brain, heart, food pipe, stomach, lungs, bones and muscles. We cannot see them from outside. They are called the internal parts. Just like Sid, we all have these internal parts in our body. Let's recap. The parts of our body that we cannot see from outside are called internal parts. The brain, heart,